वाहिगुरु जी का खालसा, वाहिगुरु जी की फतेह. वेरी वेरी ब्लेसड मोमेंट, बिकॉज आई थिंक व्हाइल थिंकिंग अबाउट दिस, व्हाइल एनविसाजिंग दिस लिटिल इंटरेक्शन, आई थिंक आई वेंट मच क्लोजर इन टू फाइंडिंग माई ओन सेल्फ, माई ओन रूट्स एंड वॉट मिशन वी आर हियर फॉर. जस्ट अ वेरी क्विक क्वेश्चन फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. बिफोर यू केम इन, यू नो आई एम श्योर यू ऑल, द फर्स्ट थिंग यू डिड वॉज यू ग्रैब्ड अ ग्लास ऑफ वॉटर. Right, we are very lucky, by the way, to be born in these years where we are only having to grab glasses of water and not having to grab cylinders of oxygen. Because a few years later, we might not be carrying those backpacks like our kids do. They take them to school with some oxygen back in the air. I was shocked to find out that Canadian air is being sold in China for about $20 per liter. Fascinating. I also have one more question. Imagine the Delhi week of work, commitments, deadlines. You guys have this great event that you planned, and I'm sure, I know what it takes to organize an event in Delhi and call as many people from different faiths together. Imagine you've had a whole lot of that, and finally you have this weekend coming, and you think, I need a break. Where would you want to go for that little break? To relieve yourself, to de-stress yourself, where would you want to go? Shimla, Nainital. We are lucky, guys. We are lucky because we are still born in this era where we have a Shimla and we have a Darjeeling and we have these cooler spaces. Because 20 years from now, if the way things are, we'll probably have to find some space in Mars to be able to get a cooler temperature like that. Because it wouldn't be here. So blessed are we. But isn't it ironic that we are having to think about? I feel kind of a mix of emotions right now. Look at what we're having to talk about, environment. Something that was given to us. We were made up for this mutual existence. God created this whole universe, they created this whole space in that interdependence, in that moment where we would understand that we are here as codependent workers, just like this co-working space, and we share this space, not own it like we were just told. We forgot that. I think it's a fundamental question. कोई भी बीमारी को समझना है तो उसके रूट तक पहुंचना पड़ेगा. Otherwise, the treatment's ineffective. Now, what 300 years ago, 400 years ago, the gurus have told us this basic wisdom that what is the cause of the problem? What is the challenge we are facing and why is this happening the way it is? Why are we so concerned and who do we blame? Where do we push off this blame? Because that's what we are experts of, by the way, Indians. Mastered the research of blaming. So who do we blame? The guru tells us that there dos na deo kise, dos karma apneya. Don't blame anybody else. Blame yourself, your own deeds, your own actions. Jo main kiya, so main paya. Dos na dijiye avarjana. Whatever you've done, that's what you're living. As you sow, so shall you reap. We are just having to reap the consequences of what we sowed years and centuries ago. And if we were to understand this basic wisdom, the basic truth of how we were created, this doctor, this expert, that one creator, if I go back to my guru, and which is the Guru Granth Sahib Ji, my guru tells me that the basic problem that you all are fighting are two main issues. One, the kaam, krodh, lobh, moh, ahankar. We all understand this, right? The five vices, the five chores. Everybody here is wanting more. Everybody here is wanting an increment, is wanting more profits. The problem today is we chose profits over wellness. We chose greed over need. We chose the rule of gold over the golden rule. And we take care. We take care of each other. I think this need of wanting more, having more, increasing our needs, the consumerism formula, the more you want, the more you seek, the better it is for the economy. This more, more, more has led us over here today that we are having to think about issues like that. It is greed. The second issue, I think man, some were believed, because they were brighter than the other species, we believe that we are the finest creation and this planet was created to serve us. Whereas if we ask the guru, The Guru tells us, sab mein jyot, jyot hai soi. Sab, everything is your, has your jyot. Your presence is everywhere. There is nothing but you, the creator. And if you're in every space, sab teri kudrat. This kudrat belongs to you. It is your creation. But we thought it is us. And we thought we are on the top of this pyramid where all these creatures or all this environment, the plants, they're all lower than us. And we are on the top, the rulers. The Guru tells us this homme that we have, this ego that we have, that I am the ruler, I am the boss. That's your problem. Homme dhira grov hai. Our homme, that I am the best. And this world is there to serve me. This homme is actually causing us the trouble, the real trouble. And the day I understand my problem, the day I understand my concerns, the Guru also gives us the prescription. The Guru also tells us what we need to do. The Guru, the Creator created us in perfect harmony. They take in what we release. We need what they give us. What a beautiful codependence. We shake that off. We earned that somewhere. And we are having to suffer. They are in perfect hukam, as I understand. Plants, animals, they are in perfect hukam. They are working in God's will. They are working in the Creator's will. It's we, the so-called intelligent people, who didn't understand that if I disturb this web, it will ultimately come back to me. What I give out, I will have to pay back one day, someday. And how beautifully nature and Lord and the Kalpur of Vaidu, that one creator, they're so similar in so many ways. They give us, when we're talking about how do we tackle this issue, I always, the first thing that comes to my mind is my environmental science classroom lesson. My teacher taught me the 3 R's. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Yeah. Now Guru taught us the same thing as well. They said that tol taram daya kapu. Your righteous living is actually the child of daya, which is compassion. Tol taram daya ka bhut santokh thap rakhya jinsu. Santokh is contentment. So if I see reduce is coming from santokh, if we could have some santokh in life, if we could start thinking, I have enough actually and I don't need more. I don't need to be running after this material and that material. I don't need to be better than these people around me. That santokh will actually get us all to reduce. And when we talk of recycle, when we talk of finding new ways, we're actually being compassionate towards the world that's given us so much, that's blessed us so much. But if we don't go back to our roots, if we don't understand the Guru's message, I think nature, just like God, just like that one creator, does not discriminate between black or white, Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Christians, rich or poor, but it will equally extinct us all if we choose not to make any effort. So I'm very glad, I'm very fortunate that we are not only discussing, but we're also bringing in some actions, we're also bringing in some shift. And our only hope is that if we can go back to that learning that has come up. I just want to end with a little story that moves me tremendously. Most of us might know that we had 10 living gurus, and the 7th guru, as a child, were playing in a garden, and they accidentally happened to have broken a flower with their robe. And with that little incident, they went into Bairag. They went into that disconnect and that pain of separation from their Lord, their one. And when their grandfather, that present guru at that time, asked them, what's wrong? Why are they so emotional? They said, accidentally I damaged a flower. And that's when their grandfather shared with them that you may be able to repair a broken building, but you may never be able to bring back this life and bring back unto the effect of many, many actions you have in your life. You know the best time to plant a tree? When is the best time to plant a tree?
No best time.
No best time? Yeah, never planted. What is the best time?
Anytime.
The best time was 15 years ago, to be honest. you would now have had some trees and fruits and many more benefits. But the next best time, like they say, is now. And that's what this guru inspires me. They went ahead to take care of nature, serve the nature. The three basic pillars that Sikh faith stands on is Naam Japo, Vandike Shapo, and Kirt Karo. Which means remember that oneness in all actions of yours throughout the day and everything you do. You're just an extension of that Lord. Make sure you're living through honest means, but all of this will go in vain if you're not serving His creation. And His creation is as much as the plants and the animals and the whole environment, as much as we are. We're just co-dependent, co-working in the space, just like together, right? So I hope that we all together are able to make a difference. Even if it's an iota of a difference, it will go a long way. And these children will not curse us for what we did to them. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.